Assalamu alaikum and good morning everyone. I am profoundly thankful to His Excellency Mr. Shinjiro Koizumi, Minister, Ministry of Environment, Government of Japan, for inviting me in this forum. I am also thankful to co-organizers, the UN, ESCAPE, ADB, UNCARD, and supporting organizations for organizing this forum. I also express my gratitude to the EST members countries for joining here. With all of us considering the COVID-19 pandemic situation, we have gathered here in a hybrid format. It reflects the importance of the event. It emphasizes the need of acting right now to bring a transformational change in the transport sector of Asia. Dear participants, we are very proud to share that our Honorable Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has been conferred with SDG Progress Award for Bangladesh's steady progress in achieving the Sustainable Development Goals in the UN-sponsored Sustainable Development Solutions Network. On the very auspicious occasion of the celebration of the birth centenary of the fathers of the nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, this achievement is addition of one more feather in the crown of the success story of the present government of Bangladesh. Our Honorable Prime Minister has become the President of the Climate Vulnerable Forum, CVF, for the second time, aiming the resilience to prosperity. Bangladesh is working on the draft Mujib Climate Prosperity Plan, Decade 2030. Foresighted leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister, such a time is ours, considering the hours. And today we all have gathered here in this forum to adopt the 2030 Archai Declaration for making transport in Asia sustainable. The Bali Declaration, the predecessor of the new 2030 EST Declaration, visions on three zones: zero congestion, zero pollution, and zero accident, as long-term guidance in ensure the full sustainability of transport in Asia. And the railway sector is the reflection of the next generation sustainable transport system. Dear participants, to keep in peace with the current economic development trend and with the existing dense population, our present government of Bangladesh has realized that urban transportation needs to be shifted into a sustainable solution. Hence, investment in the railway sector has increased significantly. Introduction of electric traction in different routes, circular rail line around Dhaka city, and high-speed train are in progress to improve the land-based transport system. Feasibility study and other preparation for these projects are underway. This sector is improving gradually. Dear participants, we firmly believe that each little step to ensure environmental sustainability counts. Considering the environmental hazard, Bangladesh Railway has moved with coal-based locomotives and petroleum-based. Currently, all the new procured locomotives are of Tier 2 standard, and the future procurement of locomotives will be Tier 2 or higher standard. The government aspires to move to electric locomotives to lessen the greenhouse gas emission. To ensure environment-friendly transportation system and zero wastage discharge to the atmosphere of Bangladesh Railway, has introduced bio-toilet facility in the coaches to reduce the wastage of water. The newly installed automatic carriage washing plants in Dhaka and Rajshahi are capable of reusing 70% of water. In order to have the most out of the land transport system, the railway system could serve the arteries and the road system as a feeder system of transportation to the interior parts and to the intermediate locations between the railway stations. Considering the facts, our present government has taken initiatives to establish multimodal hubs in Dhaka and the airport railway station of Bangladesh under public-private partnership program. Dear participants, before I conclude, I would like to draw the attention of you all that the successful implementation of the 2030 Archai Declaration lies in the mutual cooperation, bilateral and multilateral donor organization. The EST member countries have individual key role to play in the successful implementation of 2030 Archai Declaration. I humbly call upon the cooperation and assistance of all of you in this regard. Thank you all.